In this video, we're going to talk about how you can edit your files that are stored in Box. You can access Box by going to tufts.box.com and logging in with your Tufts username and password. I've already done that, so when I log in, this is what I see. Here are my folders and files. And what I want to do today is make some edits to a document that I have here in this folder. If I click on the name of the folder is going to open. Here are the subfolders and files that I have within the folder, and I want to make edits to this test document here. If I want to do that, one thing that I could do is go over to the More Options button, click on that, and a menu is going to open up, and if I go up to the top where it says Open With, I'll see some options for applications that I can use to make my edits. One of those is, because this is a Word document, Microsoft Word, which is the desktop version of that application, which I have installed on my computer, or I could choose to make my edits in Word Online, which is the version of Word that you can use right within your browser. I could also access those options by clicking into my file preview. So if I click on the name of the document here, here's my file preview, where you'd see the contents of the file and some details about it. I can't make my edits right in here, but at the top of this window, there is an open button. And if I click on the drop-down menu next to that, I see those applications again. I have the desktop version of Microsoft Word, or I can use Microsoft Word Online. We'll begin by taking a look at Microsoft Word Online. So I'm going to click here. And what that's going to do is open up that file in a new tab in my browser where I can make my edits. So I'll click in here and I'll add some text. And if you look at the top of the screen, as I make changes to this, it's going to save my changes automatically for me, which is super convenient. That means I don't have to worry about it saving this stuff manually. Now, to close out this document, all I've got to do is go to the top of this browser tab and click on the X button. And Box is going to let me know that there is a new version of that file available. And if I click refresh here, the changes that I made should be visible right in my file preview, which they are. The other option that I had was to go ahead and make my edits in the desktop version of Microsoft Word. So if I click on this, what it's going to do, Box is going to open up this file in my desktop application. So I'll go ahead and do that. And when you do that, you'll see a little message here about locking the document. So here's my document, right? The changes that I had made before had been saved. If this is a shared document, so if it's something that other people have access to and potentially are going to make edits to, then locking the document is a good idea. So the reason why you want to do that is because it'll prevent someone else from opening up the file and making changes to it while you are making changes to it. And then, you know, you guys could potentially overwrite each other's work without knowing it, and people's work would be lost. I'm going to skip this for now. So I'm just going to say close because I'm going to show you another way that you could do that. But I could go ahead and make some edits in here. And with the desktop version, it's not going to save my changes automatically. I have to save them manually. So I'm going to go ahead and click on File and Save, or you can hit Control S, and it's going to save those changes. And now when I close out of this, Box is going to let me know, okay, there's a new version. So I click on refresh, and what will happen is in my file preview now, those changes that I had made are going to show up. So I had said that locking the document is a good idea. And one of the ways that you can do that, besides that little pop-up window that we saw, is if you come to the top of the preview window here and you click on the More Options button, you'll see the option to lock your document. Now, when you click on this, you're going to see a window that asks you how long you want to lock the document for. So I would suggest not using unlimited, but maybe, you know, picking an hour, 2 hours, however long you think you might need. So I'll just say 15 minutes. And then you can disable the downloading of this file if you'd like. And once you're satisfied with that, you go ahead and click on lock, and the document is locked. So that means that right now I'm the only person who can make edits to this document, either in the desktop or in the online versions of Word, and other people can't. Now, when I'm done making my changes, because I don't want to, you know, leave people locked out any longer than I have to, what I can do is go ahead and go to the More Options button, click on that, and now I can say to Box, go ahead and unlock this document. And now it's unlocked and other people can access it if they need to. Another option that you have if you have Box Drive installed on your computer is you can open up the file right from your computer's file manager. So I have Box Drive installed, and what that means for me is that if I open up Finder on my Mac or Explorer on my PC, I'll see Box listed as a location. And what I can do when I click on that is see all of my Box files and folders. Even though they're listed here, they're not stored on my computer. They're still stored to the cloud. But I can double click on a file, in this case, my test document, and it's going to open that up in the desktop version of Word, in this case. And I can go ahead and make some changes and hit save. And with Box Drive, what that's going to do is it's going to sync those changes back up with my Box account. So as you can see here, Box is telling me I have a new version available. So I'm going to go ahead and click on refresh. And those changes that I made will show up in my file preview. Thank you for watching this video on editing files in Box. If you'd like more information, go over to the service page for Box on Access Tufts at the URL shown on the screen.